State Weather Bureau Pagasa is monitoring a low-pressure area off the waters of Davao City. Now, how will this affect the weather across the country? Let's find out from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. A low-pressure area which entered the Philippine area of responsibility yesterday is going to bring wet weather over southern Philippines. At 10 this morning, it was located 300 kilometers east-southeast of Davao City. Pagasa says it is unlikely to develop into a storm and may dissipate in the coming days. At times, heavy rains will be experienced over Bohol, eastern Visayas, and most of Mindanao this Monday. Most of Mimaropa, southern Bicol region, and the rest of Visayas will also experience scattered rains today. And landslides are possible in these areas. Meanwhile, the waning Amihan will bring light rains over Quezon, Laguna, Marinduque, Oriental Mindoro, and the rest of Bicol region. Metro Manila will be sunny and warm today, but for the remainder of the week, a fresh surge of Amihan will bring cool weather over most of Luzon starting tomorrow, will wane by Thursday, and a new surge will begin again on Friday. The shear line will form along with this Amihan surge, which will bring rains over the eastern side of the country. Two more low-pressure areas may also follow the present disturbance in the coming days. That's the latest on the weather. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Ariel Rojas there. Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel also questioning how the House can amend the Maharlika Fund bill when it was already passed on third and final reading. He says the revisions show the measure was poorly planned. He now calls on the Senate leadership to ensure any counterpart bill won't be railroaded.
Meron na silang laptop on third and final reading. Tangalam ko, pagkakalam ko, na-transmit na sa Senado. Ngayon, i-amend nila sa interview nila sa media. Paano, ano klase proseso yan? Masyado nating hindi lang nila linilito ang kapwa nilang mga mambabatas, pati taong bayan, nalilito na tuloy. Ang general na pakiusap naman ng minority sa majority, huwag madaliin kahit anong panukala, lalong-lalo na ito.
Senator Pimentel also has this piece of advice for his colleagues at the lower chamber.
Yung proponent sana nito, bago kasi ma-i-announce na pabago-bago isip tuloy, nakikita natin na hindi pinag-isipang mabuti, yung brainstorming ninyo, gawin ninyong closed door behind closed doors. We're wasting a lot of time. Ang problema natin ngayon talaga, inflation eh. Doon po tayo mag-concentrate kasi yung sa Sovereign Wealth Fund, Maharlika Fund, uubusin ng oras namin dyan. Tama na muna yan. Concentrate na tayo sa agriculture, food production.
The Philippine government vows to monitor the progress of investment pledges secured by President Marcos in his recent overseas trips. Marcos earlier revealed international investment banking firm Morgan Stanley and Swiss mining company Glencore expressed intent to expand their operations in the Philippines. That's on top of billions of dollars worth of investment commitments brought home by Marcos from his recent trip to China. The Trade Department believes upskilling the country's workforce will help unlock more opportunities for the country.
We are organizing a team that really look after all of the investment and business interests of many companies, not only for the WEF, but for all the visits. These projects will generate a lot of opportunities sa ating bansa. Very important po dito is that alam natin na ang strength ng Pilipinas ay yung ating human resources. But we need to continue to strengthen our capabilities. Naririnig po natin palagi yung term na upskilling, reskilling. Kasi po, with the new technologies and with the new requirements of the industries, kailangan po yung ating strength, which is our labor force, our human resources, have to be up to par.
The temporary release of the former chief of staff of former Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile seemed to blur the boundaries of the writ of habeas corpus. See, last week, the Supreme Court granted attorney Gigi Reyes's habeas corpus petition, saying her confinement has become capricious and oppressive. Reyes is facing plunder charges in connection with a multi-billion peso pork barrel scam. Attorney Levito Baligod, private complainant in the 2014 case, questions whether there was indeed a constitutional violation committed against Reyes.
Na-blur yung boundaries ng mga matagal mga nire-respeto na mga doktrina. Sa constitution po natin, mag-uumpisa lahat yan at sinasabi, no person shall be deprived of life, liberty, or property without due process of law. Now, nagkaroon ba ng unconstitutional deprivation of the right to liberty of Attorney Gigi Reyes, no? Makikita po naman natin sa ating batas at sa rules of court na dito sa habeas corpus, pagka naipakita ng prison officer na nire-restrain niya yung liberty ng isang nakakulong ayon sa isang kautusan ng korte, there is due process there. At for a very long time, pagka sinabi ng prison officer na naikulong po namin yan dahil sa kautusan ng korte, dinidismiss po ng Korte Suprema ang petition for habeas corpus.